So, got an email from the average picker this morning talking about how it's going to be hard to get these open and that I shouldn't be too hard on myself if I can't get it the first time around. And I'm well aware of that. I have no doubt about my skill level here being somewhere around, let's say average at best. Okay, this is a tight little keyway. I might need my 15,000 picks. Let's see. But, I figured I'd give it a try anyway. And, if battery on the camera gives out, then before I'm done, then, I can try again another day. So we'll see. He's also suggesting I use Coptic Keyway Tension, which is why I'm using one of my homemade picks here to do just that. Let's use the Crazy Gem from Peterson's. Shrike line of picks. Fit in here a little better. Kind of not. I think I'm gonna grab the 15,000 picks and see if I have any more luck there. I have two of them that I unknowingly bought many years ago. And about my first set of lock picks. So here is the gem, regular gem, not the crazy gem, or gem crazy. Okay, I'm not getting much from one. We'll see. Try two. A little more resistance. You hear that, although I'm pretty sure that was a pin dropping. Let's go back to one. And even with a 15,000 pick, this is a tight cube. Might need to snag a few more of these. Okay, one's not giving me anything. Try to get to two. Two's not giving me anything. Three or four is definitely giving me a good deal of resistance. Just want to focus on picking and not on the camera. Okay. Let's backtrack a little. So we got one. I gotta light it up for myself. One's giving me nothing. I think it's already set. Two's not giving me anything. Three seems like it's probably set. Getting something from five, like quick there. It's dropping down pretty fast. Probably still in contact with the spring. Yeah, it's definitely more to gravity, especially at an angle. I believe that's 6. It's not giving me any play. Nothing on 1 again. Nothing on 2. Nothing on 3. Put there on 4 again. It's something on 4. Turn the light off. I'm actually closing my eyes right now, just trying to focus on what I feel. We've got an any counter rotation, so that's interesting. Of course, I do not know what kind of pins are in here. But I do know this is not a challenge. Count off one more time, and I think I'm gonna have to reset everything. Oh, something dropped. Okay, let's go with 1. Give that a good push. Click out of 2, but now I'm not feeling it. Is it there? I overset. Maybe. No, that's 5. And 6. Down to 1 bar on the camera, so we'll see. Of course, it should beep at me to let me know it's stopped recording. Okay, so I'm going to try resetting these. Okay, definitely got a bunch of pins to drop. I'm also going to snag this tension wrench I just made for this specific block. I'm pretty sure I determined that was cut too much. Yeah, I wasn't happy about it with it anyway, so I think I'm going to chop this whole thing off and re-bend it. Let's see if the other end will work at all. Of course, the bent tension wrenches don't give nearly as the twisted ones when they're twisted sideways. It's easier to hold them, but they don't give quite as much feedback. Although for me, the advantage is it's harder to over-tension a lock. That was two for a big pop on two. Getting a good deal of resistance on three. Do not want to over. I'm not going to put too much pressure, especially on a 15,000th pick. The 25,000th pick will bend easily. And just think how. Well, not easily, but if I can bend those pretty without realizing it, I'm pretty sure that it won't be very hard to bend the significantly thinner ones. Oh, that was painful. Two popped up just good, and then the tension wrench got loose. The two must have reset itself, so that's... Let's focus in on feeling the pins. Okay, so there goes. Two or three. Now this is three or four. I'm definitely getting some resistance. Again, I'm trying not to push too hard. Making some counter rotation here. Nothing on one, nothing on two. A little bit of resistance on three, but I'm not sure if I'm hitting just the pin. Also hitting. It's too much. Just click on four. Just keep sliding the pick too far. That doesn't fit at all. They're going to grab out this reach pick, which I held two of at one point, but one went missing while I was holding onto it. some things. One set, two seam set, three seam set. Getting little clicks out of five and six. Let's give this a little look. Okay, so 6 is going to need quite a bit more leverage than... No. Other way around. 5 is going to need quite a bit more leverage. 4 and 5 will need more leverage than the rest of the pins. Try to find 5. Okay. Okay, just stick it on the back of the lock. There's 6 falls down. Now I'm on 5. Beep out of the camera. Not sure what that means. Probably gonna quit at the 20-minute mark. Sometimes just going a little zoned out, just focusing on a lock. It's an award, reward in and of itself. It'd be nice if the television in the first apartment wasn't so loud. But it's on that little old lady who can't hear very well, so I totally understand why she needs to crank it up so. It's very amusing. She listens to her Christian music reading. Quite a loud volume. Especially in the middle of the night. Well, hit the 20-minute mark, and I'm not making a ton of progress, so I think now's a good time to give it a quit, and come back to this later. Although one thing I do want to do is stick the key in here, and get some idea of how much pressure I need to be putting on these tension wrenches to get it open. Next to nothing. Interesting. Although I have heard the tension. Well, the AP warned me that tensioning sergeant locks can be a little tricky. Okay, folks. Hope everyone's having a good day. And that we can all enjoy our lock picking, whether we get an open or not. Thanks, folks. Bye.